build a town, build it fast. If we don't let scientists bring their families, we'll never get the best.
One could be forgiven for thinking that Christopher Nolan's recent release, Oppenheimer, is all about the tortured genius titular protagonist. However, the people in his orbit who shaped him and impacted him have also been captured into narrative. One of the key characters in Robert Oppenheimer's life was his wife, Kitty Oppenheimer, a role mastered to perfection by the talented Emily Blunt. She had been through the thick and thin of her husband's career and even supported him in his worst phase. But what happened to her after the events of the movie? In this video, we will explore further into this character and also bring you the fate of Kitty Oppenheimer. Who is Kitty Oppenheimer and how did she meet Robert? She was born in Germany as Catherine Pliening and she grew up in Pittsburgh. Kitty had a rather privileged upbringing courtesy of her wealthy family in an upscale neighborhood. She hailed from a royal family and she went on to have an educational background that was sound enough to stimulate the intellect of someone like Oppenheimer. After pursuing various courses across some of the most prestigious universities in the country, she found her interest in botany. She met Robert Oppenheimer after a series of failed relationships with their chemistry. Was something to savor. They first met at a garden party in the year 1939, shortly after Oppenheimer had broken up with his longtime partner Jean Tadlock. They hit it off instantly, and soon a relationship blossomed even though she was still married to her then-husband, Dr. Richard Harrison. Previously, she had been married to a musician named Frank Ramsager, and this relationship was annulled within a few months. Her next marriage was to a communist organizer named Joseph Dalit, who died during the Spanish Civil War, where he was actively involved. This was followed by a third marriage to Richard, but after her involvement with Oppenheimer, the marriage was doomed for a divorce. Things got further complicated because she became pregnant with Oppenheimer's child, and they eventually managed to reach an amicable agreement. Oppenheimer married her following the divorce procedure, and they briefly lived in California before the Manhattan Project led him away. Kitty Oppenheimer and her responsibilities as the wife of the director of Manhattan Project. One of the most distinct personalities of Kitty Oppenheimer was her ability to hold her own and assuming her responsibilities effortlessly. It was no exception when she had to move to New Mexico after Oppenheimer was appointed as the director of the Manhattan Project. She was always a source of great support in her husband's career, and she stuck with him even through this challenging race in his career. Even though she was pregnant, she continued her studies and pursued her ambitions to become a botanist. She also worked as a lab technician briefly and studied the health hazards that are associated with radiation. Kitty Oppenheimer was known for having a sharp tongue, and this outspoken nature came in handy during the rigorous interrogations while Oppenheimer was being investigated later. The common friends of the couple have revealed that Oppenheimer could lean on his wife for the much-needed support and motivation that he required. She was happy to be a part of the rapidly advancing career of Oppenheimer, but she had had a few struggles of her own. She also became pregnant with her second child during her stay in the research facility for the Manhattan Project. The isolation and responsibilities couldn't have been great for her mental health, but she handled everything like a pro. Alcoholism could not deter her passion. Kitty Oppenheimer dealt with some major issues in her personal life that ranged from their child being terminally ill to disturbing reports of Oppenheimer's affair with his ex. She reportedly had an alcohol problem, and combined with a nasty habit of popping pills for everything and smoking heavily, it took a toll on her health. Her views on communism were always static, and even though she suffered from depression and health issues, she held on to her ideals. This is evident when the way she handled a security hearing against her husband during the 50s when Oppenheimer was accused of being sympathetic toward the communist cause. Previously, she had served as the Communist Party's literary agent, and she was also involved with various protests against the neutrality shown by the West in the Spanish Civil War. Oppenheimer did the best on his part to calm her down and even built a greenhouse and got some exotic plants for her to fuel her hobby. Her crucial role in the security hearing. It is safe to say that Kitty Oppenheimer fared much better than her husband during the series of interrogations that the couple was subjected to. The movie captures this beautifully, where they even included many of her real-life testimonies, and these lines added the realistic touch in Emily Blunt's performance. She remained composed throughout the process and answered each question with certainty and confidence. In her efforts to clear the name of her husband, she stood by her husband in these troubled times, and her answers are regarded by many as one of the decisive factors and forming a public opinion in his favor. Kitty Oppenheimer's final days, solitude, and disease. Her health issues continued to worsen as she aged, and it was a great personal loss for her when her husband passed away in the year 1967. However, she still continued to pursue her passion and became a yacht captain, sailing to the Caribbean and even planning to sail to Japan. Almost 11 years after her husband's death in 1978, she contracted an intestinal infection and embolism in her right arm. And alas, finally, she breathed her last the same year, and at the age of 62, ended the life that was so full of spirit and positivity despite all the odds being stacked against her. She left behind two of her children, Peter and Catherine, and she is still regarded as the capable wife of a genius who spent a lifetime being haunted by his own invention. It takes a special kind of genius to perfect this storytelling about an event that shaped human history in a way. Oppenheimer is a cinematic marvel and yet another masterpiece in Nolan's illustrious career, and we strongly recommend you to go for the theater experience for this one. Do let us know about your thoughts on Oppenheimer and his crucial role, and also tell us what you think of his wife Kitty and her impactful role in his life.